For anyone who hasn't had a chance to see The Seasoning House, it's harrowing. It's a brutal watch. There's no getting away from that. But there is a... It's not popcorn. It's not... I don't think for one second... What I love about it is it's not what I would call a car park movie, you know, where you watch it and then by the time you get to the car park, you've forgotten about it. This really fires up conversation. You know, you will talk about it and you will have debates about it as well, because what goes on within the film is going on in life as we speak. It's going on in our backyard, you know, whether it be Rotherham or Oxford or in the West End of London, and it's going on in other places of the world. So yeah, we've got the sex slave trade industry being portrayed in the movie. We've got brutality from the male upon female brutality, women being brutalized. And some very intriguing character studies. There's a lot of depth there as well, and you're wondering where this is all going to go and where it's going to come out. And also, it's not. Thank God, it's not one of these a nasty little torture porn flick. You know, there's a serious content to this, and I'm hoping that's what people are going to notice when they go in there. And it's poetic. That's the thing I really love about it. The way the film moves, the way it's been crafted, there is a real poetry to the feeling of it, and. There's a lot of wonderful metaphors in there about men and women and life like that in general, yeah. I was excited by the role because, well, I was very flattered from the point of view that Paul, who's a very old friend, had said that he'd never had anybody else in mind to play Victor. So that's always very flattering when you're number one choice. And I read the script, read it in one sitting, loved it, didn't get distracted, and said, yeah, well, let's go. If everything comes together in the background from the production point of view, I think we're off to the races, because it's going to make a really, really good movie. And preparation, as always, homework. I keep boring people to death with that word, but that's what it is. And just doing what you have to do to get to this guy. Well, we all got on like a house on fire. It was great. There was a lot of energy that had to be spent on this film, and it was a very short shooting schedule, so there were very long days. It was a tight shoot, and it was long and days, and so there was a lot of tiredness there at times, but we all had to be very focused, because it was work, but we had our moments of levity in the little green room that we had, and we had a bit of a laugh, and some of them were playing a bit, we all having a bit of go at Fruit Ninja on the iPads and things like that, so we all had our moments of keeping that nice in the background. But when it's time to work, it's time to work, and everybody was ready. Everybody. Rosie, Sean, rock and roll. Just get on with it. And that was nice. That was really nice to have that around you. Yeah. It's her debut feature. It's like she hadn't been in front of like on a film set in that sense before. I know she'd done a little bit of TV and different things before, but this was really film, and the creative process of that is very different from TV, of course. And when you're the center of it, and it's really like your story, there's a lot to do. She worked incredibly hard. And, you know, not only with the sort of like getting the whole essence of the character from a point of view is with no dialogue because she's a deaf mute and everything, but the physical side of the acting as well, crawling through the vents. Unbelievable. Before the film actually even took place, I was very much into what the Helen Bamba Foundation was doing anyway. I didn't get involved because I was filming something else at the time, but I remember there was Emma Thompson got very heavily involved in doing some very hard-hitting public awareness kind of film campaigns about the sex slave trade industry, and I remember when that was going on, and I've been fascinated with it since then, not in a vicarious thrill way or anything at all, but just how grotesque it really is and how awful it, and the fact that it's going on in our backyard, you know, whether it be Rotherham, we've had it in Rotherham, we've had it in Oxford. I mean, that was the weird thing when we were filming. This stuff was happening. We were getting newspapers were coming out and we were reading about it and saying, my God, look at this. You know, there's a whole bunch of guys who are doing this to these girls and they've been doing it for a decade. And you just think, my God, this is in our backyard. This isn't a war zone. This isn't... So that was... I'm fascinated to see it change. I want the law and I want the legal side to do everything they can to just smash these kind of things, because it's just horrendous.